We begin with the latest tragic details of the deadly stabbing rampage in Sydney's Bondi Junction. Six people were murdered in the attack. Four have been identified. New mother, Ash Good, architect, Jade Young, Dawn Singleton, daughter of businessman John Singleton, and security guard, Faraz Tahir. Another 12 people were wounded, including Ash's nine-month-old baby girl. The killer has been named as 40-year-old Joel Cauchi. He was stopped by New South Wales Police Inspector Amy Scott. She ran towards Cauchi and opened fire, ending his deadly rampage. Hers is just one story of remarkable bravery in an incident that's shaken the nation. Taylor Ryan begins our coverage, and a warning, this report is confronting.
Hours before he murdered half a dozen innocent people inside a busy shopping centre, Joel Cauchi ordered a chicken curry at this Bondi Junction cafe. He couldn't pay, but returned 2 hours later with cash for what would be his final meal, before he stumbled down the street and shortly after began a killing spree inside the busy Westfield.
Sydney has suffered a horrifying and violent attack on innocent people who are doing something everybody does on the weekend, and that is going shopping.
The events of yesterday have shocked the nation.
40-year-old Cauchi first entered the centre at around 3 p.m. He left, then returned 20 minutes later armed with a knife and began his attack on innocent shoppers. Men, women and children fled for their lives and barricaded themselves inside stores, while others fled out the back through fire exits. Brave onlookers tried their best to disarm Cauchi. A male security guard is among the dead. The other five victims are all women.
He was determined on stabbing people, but he stabbed women, mainly old women, which is quite cowardly, really.
The harrowing attack continued until 4 p.m. as Cauchi made his way up to the higher levels of the centre before he came face to face with New South Wales Inspector Amy Scott, who demanded Cauchi drop his weapon. When he didn't, he was shot dead.
We're all lucky that she was there, you know, because he would have done a lot more damage.
Still, a lot of damage was done. Among the dead, Sydney architect Jade Young, 25-year-old Dawn Singleton, the daughter of prominent businessman John, security guard Faraz Tahir, and 38-year-old first-time mum Ash Good. Her baby girl, Harriet, has undergone surgery and remains in hospital, along with a dozen others whose lives were saved thanks to the selfless, quick thinking of strangers.
I'll do the best I can, but some of the injuries those people sustained were really bad, so we just did the best with what we could. We were literally using clothes off the shelves and...
Lifeguard Andrew Reid was shopping at Maya when the attack started.
I looked down to level four because I could see through the escalators and there was a woman down there just bleeding really badly, and I was like, I've got to get down there and help. And as I went past this empty pram, I was just like, what's this pram doing here? You know, I've got three young kids and, yeah, I just felt sick in my stomach.
Those who fled into nearby shops could do nothing but wait.
I was hiding in the back room and I was just hearing gunshots. It was just like the worst thing ever.
Lock the glass doors, turn off the lights, turn off the music and get us all to hide in the storeroom.
Before police went store to store, securing the centre and brought people to safety. One by one, they emerged from the Westfield, and by the time the evening set in, the world was reacting.
To Australia now and a terrifying scene at a mall in Sydney.
From King Charles, our hearts go out to the families and loved ones of those who have been so brutally killed during such a senseless attack. But if it wasn't for the actions of one determined police officer, yesterday's death toll could have been even higher.
And can I just say how proud we are of the actions of the officer involved last night. She will be is receiving all the support that she requires.
Inspector Amy Scott is being hailed a hero for taking on the offender and putting an end to his deadly rampage.
This state owes her an enormous debt of gratitude.
Alongside the remarkable members of the public who risked their own lives to save others.
We also see the footage of ordinary Australians putting themselves in harm's way in order to help their fellow citizens. That bravery was quite extraordinary. The best of Australians amidst this extraordinary tragedy.
A deadly tragedy that police say was not an act of terrorism, but the terror felt by those who survived can't be forgotten.
And Taylor Ryan joins us live from Bondi Junction. And Taylor, as police predicted, it's still very much an active crime scene there.
Chris, the Westfield remains closed to the public tonight, but outside where we are, the number of floral tributes only continues to grow. The pile behind me has been getting bigger by the hour. There's a really emotional feeling in the air as the community here struggles to reconcile the events that took place yesterday. As you mentioned, the Westfield itself does remain a crime scene. Police will remain in there this evening. The only difference is today they have finally allowed some people to come in and slowly remove their vehicles. I have to say, though, for most people here this evening, the reopening of the centre, we're not clear when that will be yet, but for most people, that's truly the last thing on their minds. Everyone's thoughts here very much with the victims tonight and their families.
Thanks, Taylor. Taylor Ryan there, live from Bondi Junction. We're today learning more about the victims killed in this tragedy, a refugee who tried to fight Joel Cauchi, a young bride-to-be and a Sydney architect. They're among those being remembered today for who they were, not for how they died.
A sea of flowers growing as waves of insurmountable grief hit the community for the loss of six people robbed of their futures. A besotted new mother, a 25-year-old bride-to-be, counting down the months to her big day. A mum of two raising her family in Bellevue Hill. A security guard who lost his own life, protecting others. And two women from overseas, thousands of kilometres away from their families.
She just was a beautiful soul. She never said anything bad about anyone and she just wanted to be a mum and she'd been given that opportunity and then 9 months later, it's gone and it's, yeah, I can't, yeah.
Andrew Reid tried desperately to save some of the victims, not realising his friend of 10 years, Ash Good, was among those fatally wounded. This is the woman he remembers. Bright, always smiling, and a beautiful person.
Beautiful baby was 9 months old and, yeah, it was all, you know, it was all ahead of her and that was just taken away in the blink of an eye and it's horrible.
From Ash's family today, she was a beautiful mother, daughter, sister, partner, friend, all-round, outstanding human and so much more. While her daughter, also injured by the same attacker, after hours of surgery is doing well, we are so grateful for the expert care and attention of the medical team. Ash's family asking that this photo be how she is remembered and not for the crime that killed her.
Remember the woman. Remember who she was, which was that kind, loving, peaceful, present, athletic, brilliant woman.
The 38-year-old and her partner, who was also injured, are known and loved across Australia. The South Australian Premier, a family friend.
I've been speaking on the phone this morning to a family member. It's pretty bad. It is incomprehensible that such a beautiful family has been so aggressively affected.
Unimaginable pain felt also by the family of Dawn Singleton, the 25-year-old daughter of media magnate John Singleton, murdered in the shopping centre attack. She was the apple of her father's eye, her nickname Dawnie Perfect, given to one of his racehorses. Police today speaking with the family in their Vaucluse home.
Now, whether you know the individuals who've been killed or not, you're grieving today. And the entire state we'll have to get behind those families in the days ahead.
Dawn was months away from getting married. Her partner, a serving police officer from her former school. It is devastating to learn of the death of Kambala old girl Dawn, Dawnie Singleton. Each victim of this horrible crime is being remembered today. Architect and mother of two, Jade Young, as a lovely, kind-hearted woman. A devoted member of the Bronte Surf Lifesaving Club. 30-year-old security guard and former refugee Faraz Tahir also killed. Those who loved him today honoured his unwavering dedication and kindness. A man who fled persecution in Pakistan and tried to protect innocent people under attack in his new home. Six people, loved, loving, and lost to us all. Samara Gardner for 10 News First.
10 people remain in hospital following the attack, including the 9-month-old baby daughter of victim Ash Good. Keziah Dawn is outside the Sydney Children's Hospital. Keziah, what's the latest on the baby's condition?
Chris, that 9-month-old baby girl is critical and in ICU as we go to air this evening, but she is stable. Friends of family have visited the hospital here today, but as you can imagine, it is an incredibly distressing time. Now, I can also confirm there are 9 other patients in hospitals around Sydney. That brings the total to 10. Now, I'll run you through where some of those are. We have 2 in St. Vincent's, 1 24-year-old male and 1 22-year-old female are both in ICU. They came in last night with stab wounds. Another elderly woman presented herself this morning. She was running from the ordeal, and she remains in the hospital as well. 2 are at Royal Prince Alfred. 1 male is in a stable condition on a ward. 1 female is in ICU. 2 females are at Prince of Wales. They are both stable, as well as another at St. George. And a woman is in ICU at Royal North Shore. She is still in a serious condition. However, she is stable. Now, St. Vincent's released a statement today sending well wishes to all of those who still have a long road to recovery. They also confirmed that the Premier, Chris Minns, and the Health Minister, Ryan Park, visited the hospital today to say thank you to emergency and ICU staff. They did that without media, but Chris, staff at hospitals right across Sydney have worked tirelessly, but there is still a long way to go.
Thanks, Keziah. Keziah Dawn joining us live from the Sydney Children's Hospital. The man behind the deadly rampage is 40-year-old Joel Cauchi, a man with a history of mental illness and a fascination with knives and guns. He was known to police and had recently been offering his services as a sex worker. His history and movements are now the subject of intense investigation. One line of inquiry: was he deliberately targeting women?
The childhood home of Toowoomba schoolboy Joel Cauchi, a teenage loner, now one of modern Australia's worst mass killers.
Oh, well, it was a shock when I heard his, heard his name.
Neighbours, some of whom today asked for anonymity, were gobsmacked.
Oh, just a quiet sort of fella,
As his parents laid low.
The family have cooperated with the Queensland Police Service.
Yesterday, like everyone else, police say they were shocked by his deadly rampage.
They saw the footage and believed it may well have been their son, so they reached out to assist authorities.
Cauchi, who was 40 and had schizophrenia, had moved from Queensland to Sydney, where police here say his actions, while terrifying, were not terrorism.
We don't know a motive. What we do understand so far is that there's no ideological motivation.
He'd posted on Facebook just 6 days ago, "Hi, I'm surfing Bondi this afternoon if anyone wants to meet there for a surf." But more concerning, this post from 2020. "I am looking for groups of people who shoot guns, including handguns, to meet up with, chat with and get to know."
This man wielded a deadly weapon in the form of a knife. But if it was an automatic gun, then we would have been speaking about hundreds of deaths.
But acquaintances say it was knives Cauchi was fixated on. And with this 30-centimetre blade, he caused carnage.
We understand that he drew it out of his backpack, but where it came from before that will be subject to the investigation.
Cauchi had no fixed home in Sydney, but had rented a 1 cubic metre storage locker.
Whatever is in it will be form part of the investigation, but it hasn't certainly indicated anything more that goes to motive.
A boogie board is among the innocuous items found. And it seems he was no stranger to Bondi. 24 hours before his killing spree, he was seen inside the same shopping centre.
He seemed really agitated put out in a bit of a rush, looking over the railing.
And he says wearing the same green and yellow jersey.
Walked towards me and I stepped out of the way and I noticed he had a bit of an odour to himself.
He was erratic too while ordering that curry in the Bondi Mall just hours before the attack.
He just looked like confused, you know, just like, when taking order, it's taking like a long and just, order chicken and curry, just like that.
In recent times, Cauchi had offered his services as a sex worker with profiles on numerous escort websites. He was known to police in both states primarily for mental health issues.
He has not been prosecuted or arrested or charged for any offence within Queensland, and he has no record within the courts for a domestic violence order.
But video from Westfield shows him abandoning his pursuit of several men. Five of the six victims who died were women.
And obviously that will be an obvious line of inquiry, and that's concerning, but that will form part of the investigation. I mean, anyone seeing that footage can see that for themselves.
Traditionally, active armed offenders will be indiscriminate with what's happening with their target selection, so they'll just try and get to as many people. And you saw through a range of the footage that we've seen that he was being selective with the targets that he would go to.
As well as those mobile phone videos, all of Cauchi's movements from out here in the mall through the doors of Westfield and his entire rampage were captured on security camera. The whole crime, from start to finish, shown from hundreds of horrible angles.
In circumstances like this, many in the community will feel real anger. We'll have to process that grief in the days ahead.
It is 12 months to the day since Sydney paramedic Stephen Toga was stabbed to death, the Premier acknowledging the accused killer there was mentally ill too.
We know we need to do more. The coroner will lead the investigation.
Cauchi's home, his high school, his history may hold some answers, but they won't undo the horror he's left behind. Daniel Sutton for 10 News First.